Hi everyone, I hope you're good. I thought I can come live to give you a nice free lesson. It's going to be, as usual, a Lebanese Arabic lesson. And when I say Lebanese Arabic, it means it's the Levantine dialect. The Levantine dialect is spoken in Lebanon, Jordan, Palestine, and Syria. And it's one of the most widely spoken dialects in the Arab world. So if you choose to speak it, it's going to be a dialect that people will generally understand. Okay, so I thought I can do a pronunciation lesson for, I would say, beginners, because a lot of times I get questions about, but this is a lesson actually that can be useful for everyone, even if you're not a beginner, because I always get questions about how to transcribe. Because usually when we're, okay, spoken Arabic actually is not a language that is written in a standard way, so there's no right or wrong way to write it. And a lot of times when we're speaking it informally, when I'm typing a message to my friend or my sister or a brother, any family member, we tend to use the Roman alphabet to write in Arabic. For example, if I want to say kelb, okay, kelb, I write K-A-L-B in English. Okay, and people read it kelb, okay, rather than writing the letter kaf in Arabic and then the lam and then the b. Okay, so I have here some of the sounds that are not easy to pronounce in Arabic. Okay, so if you know how to pronounce these sounds and how to write them when you're transcribing, and it means you can pronounce anything in Arabic if you can pronounce these sounds, okay? And as I said, even when it comes to transcribing, there's no right or wrong way to write an actual word. But, people write them differently, especially when it comes to the Roman alphabet. But there is kind of a common way of writing it, okay? So I'm gonna start with this one. Yalla, say out loud with me the whole time. Hi, everyone. Yalla, say out loud with me all the time. So basically, do you see the in reverse or in the correct way? Tell me. I don't even know if you're seeing it. I think you're seeing it in reverse, no? Shoo, guys. Is it in reverse? Let me know. If it's in reverse, I'm gonna... I think it's in reverse, yeah. So I have to... I discovered it 2 days ago. I have to click reverse and then mirror. And then now you can see it, right? Yes. Okay, but I have to be sure to hold it this way. Okay, so basically, look, there is here KH, and the actual letter in English is this one. It's a bit difficult to hold it now because, okay, kh. This is the kh, okay, and there is a dhamma on it, khu, khu. So in English, I wrote KHU to actually represent that sound. So it's not khu, no, it's kh, kh, khu. So basically, for that letter, for the letter kha, you can represent it as a kh. A lot of times you will see people write a number 5 to represent the letter kha. Why do you think they write a number 5? Can you guess? Why do you think we can write a number 5? Anyone knows? It's something that has to do like something about seeing visually. Shoo. Yes, it actually looks like a number 5, but written backwards, right? That's why a lot of times people use a number 5 to represent that sound that doesn't exist in other languages. The sound kh doesn't exist in French, doesn't exist in English. So basically, when you're using the Roman alphabet, you have to create some letters that don't exist in English, okay? So that's what... Whoops! One second. Wait, let me refix my tripod. Okay, so that's why people need a way to write the KH. So, kh, yalla, say with me the sound kh. It's like a spitting sound. When you're spitting, you don't go like kh, kh, kh. No, you go kh, kh. You're clearing your throat, right? So that's why it's khu, khu, okay? Khu, say it with me. Now, this one has a kasra under it. The kasra, this little kasra under it is the I sound, I. So that's khi. So that's why, you see, I wrote kh and I, khi. Okay? So before that, I wrote khu, khu, because this kha has a dhamma, and this dhamma gives the u sound. U, okay? U. That's why I wrote kh, which is the kh, and then u here, khu. Okay? So, khi, as I said, is the kasra. Here, this one, khi. And this one is kha. The kh is with the fatha. This line here above the kh gives the a. A sound. That's why KH together with the A, kh, kh, okay? People struggle because if you're an English speaker, maybe you never pronounced kh in your life. You probably have pronounced a k, but not a kh. That's why it's easier if you think about it as like a spitting sound, as I said, kh, 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 okay? So, kh, say it out loud with me, khu, and okay, now, hi everyone, I love you too. Yalla, I'm gonna comment later on. So, yalla, this was the first one. So, if you know how to pronounce the kha, you're one step closer to pronouncing Arabic in the correct way. Okay, so kha, khu, khi. And as I said, you can either represent it with a kh, or you can represent it because, like the number five, because it looks, the actual letter in Arabic looks like a number five. Okay, so that's kha, khu, khi. Let's try a couple of words. So these are words I took from these papers. I took them from a standard Arabic lesson, but I tried to choose the words that are also pronounced in Levantine Arabic or Lebanese Arabic. So one of the words is, yalla, say with me, is it karuf? Oh my god, it's very confusing, the side of the... Okay, this one. Is it kharuf or karuf? It's not karuf, right? It's kharuf, kh, kharuf. That's why it's written with a kh. And also, if... it. Okay, and more than anything, it requires people to be consistent, and you need a roadmap to learn it from A to B to C to D. Okay, so there is a way to learn it. Yalla. So kharuf يعني sheep بالإنجليزي. Okay, kharuf يعني sheep بالإنجليزي. Kharuf means sheep in English. Thank you. Kharuf يعني sheep. Okay, now the second word, yalla, how do I pronounce it? Say with me, yes or no. Kiyar, kiyar, sah, is it correct? Kiyar, I'm gonna wait. K, kiyar. Shu, kif nalfuz ala al-kelme? How do we pronounce the word? Okay, it's no. Is it khiyar, khiyar? Shu, khiyar. Like a spitting sound. Is it? Yes, okay. Khiyar. Khiyar, يعني cucumber. So yalla, memorize some words. Take them as a bonus, okay? So, khiyar, يعني cucumber. Kharuf, kharuf, يعني sheep. Kharuf. So, we're done with the first sound. And we're done with the way we write it. Yalla, let's go to another sound. Another one, I showed you the khaz. Another one is... Maybe it's not even different from all the languages, but I just chose to write it with a R. It's just the letter R. But the difference is that in Arabic, we roll the R, we say R. We don't say R like Italians, but we don't say R like, you know, in English, okay? It's a R, R. So instead of like saying rabbit, R, say R, R. R, rabbit, rabbit. And we actually write it as an R because the letter R does exist in English. So we don't have to create something else, okay? Just keep in mind, we don't say R, we say R, R. For example, so this one has a R with a Dhamma. Remember that tiny comma on the letter, that's the U sound, U. So that's why when you have a R, that's the letter R, Ra, with the Dhamma, so that's R, R. Whenever there is a line above the letter, that's the A sound, A. So that's why it's Ra, Ra. And then whenever you have a line under the letter, you see that little line under the letter? So that's the I sound. That's why here I wrote ri, ri. Okay? So it's ra, ru, ri. It's not ra, ru, ri. It's ra, ru, ri. I just have one word here, which is ruh, r, ruh. Ruh means go away, ruh. Okay, and ruh also means soul. That's why if you want to pamper someone, the person you love, and you want to tell them, oh, my love, we say my soul in Arabic, and it's ruhi, okay, ruhi. So ruh in the masculine form, if you're saying to someone, go away, ruh. And if you want to say it to a girl, go away, you say ruhi. It's not ruhi, and it's not ruhi like Italians, it's ruhi. Ruhi, okay, so ruh and ruhi. But the word ruh also means soul. It has two completely different meanings, soul. So when you say to someone, you're my soul, you say ruhi, ruhi. Or you can also say, like Cheese and Naps is saying, ya ruhi. You can add the word ya before. When you say ya ruhi, like, oh my soul, or hey my soul. It's not an informal word, by the way. You can say it to anyone in the street, anyone of your friends, even in a formal setting, even if it's the queen, you can use ya before it, okay? Ya ruhi, oh my soul. For now, just memorize ruhi, ruhi, my soul, you're my soul. You can use it to pamper your loved ones, okay? Ruhi. So that's in terms of the pronunciation of the letter ra, we are done. So we did the pronunciation of the letter kha. By the way, those of you who are joining now and you didn't watch the beginning of this lesson, I always end up uploading the lessons to my YouTube page, where I have longer and much more intensive lessons than TikTok, and also on my Instagram if you want. So this lesson, you will find it on my Instagram, Globetrot with Arabic, or on my YouTube, Globetrot with Arabic. So basically, we did the pronunciation of the kha, the letter kha, and how we write it in the Roman alphabet. We did the pronunciation of the letter ra, which we pronounce as a r in Arabic. Yalla, the next one. Yeah, I'm trying to make it from the easiest to the most difficult. We have here G H E, and the actual letter in Arabic is like a number 3 with a dot. It's the name of the letter. It's the letter Ghain, Ghain, R, R. I have a video on how to pronounce it, but I'm gonna quickly repeat here. So basically, again, this little dash under the letter, what sound does it give? Is it the A sound, or the U sound, or the E sound? Tell me. Shu. A, U, or E? There is a hint here. Yeah, E. So it's together with the rain, together with the rain, it's ri, ri, r. I'm going to tell you how to pronounce it in a second. So we represent that letter rein as a GH. It's not a G, it's a R. It's the same place where you pronounce the G, G sound. Okay? Now, I'm going to explain in a second how to pronounce it, but let's go over again the short vowels that are on the letters. There is a little dash now on top of the letter. So is it the A sound, the U sound, or the E sound? Yes, so that's the ra, a sound. So ra, together ra. And what about, I'm going to cover here, what about this one? What sound does it give? A, u, or e? The dhamma. It's called the dhamma. This one gives the u sound. Very good. So together with the rain, it's ru. So say with me out loud. Ri, ri, ri. It's not ri. Okay, how do we pronounce it? If you have a glass of water, I don't have a glass of water here. Put some water and try to gargle. When you gargle, you go the water is in your throat. So so basically, you're activating that part of your throat that you use to actually pronounce the letter rein. Thank you, merci elak or elik, okay? So you're activating the part of your throat where you pronounce the letter rein. So try to bring a glass of water, put a little bit, because when you put a lot, you start to choke, okay? So it's r, 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 that sound, r, and if you add e to it, it's ri, ri. So the problem, if you're a French speaker, this is very easy for you because it's like the French letter R, okay? But some people can't pronounce this R. By the way, if you can't pronounce it now or you've never pronounced it, it doesn't mean you will never be able to pronounce it. Think of it as something your body never tried, like biologically, you never tried it, you never used that anatomy in your throat to produce these letters. But once you keep practicing, like when you go to dance, you learn to dance, right? One step after another. That's the same thing that applies when it comes to pronunciation. Okay, so some people, most of my students who can't pronounce the rein, they confuse it with the r. So basically, look at the difference between the r and the r. The r is here in your throat. So as I said, you can gargle. Put some water and gargle. The r, your tongue here, is touching here, the top part of your teeth, r, 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 and it's rolling, okay? R, r, your tongue is up, r, whereas the r, you see my tongue is stable, it's not even moving. Look, I'm gonna exaggerate. R, r, you see my tongue is not doing any actions when I'm pronouncing the letter r. Rein, that's the name of the letter, rein. So basically, you represent it with a GH when we're writing informally to friends. The only word that I have with me here is raba, but in actually Levantine Arabic, specifically in Lebanon, we don't, as I said, this I took it from my MSA lessons previously. So in Levantine Arabic, we pronounce the A as a E, rebe, rebe. Rebe, rebe, yani forest. Thank you, Michi. Okay, so rebe, forest. Say it out loud with me. Rebe, rebe, rebe. So ra, okay, ru, and ri. Ra, ru, ri. Mish ra, ru, ri. Ra. Let me think about another word where there is the letter rein. He hugged me. Ramarne. This is a little bit difficult to pronounce because there is the rein, r, and there is another r. Ramarne. Ramarne. He hugged me. Ramarne. So, how do you think? I mean, one of the ways, as I said, there is no right and wrong way to write the rein. But how do you think you can write the word ghamar? Yes, ghaime. But if you want to write it with the Roman alphabet, how would you write ghamarne? Ghamarne. Both in Arabic and Roman alphabet. Would you type it for me? Gha. 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 Marne. Ghamarne. I'm gonna wait. Yes. Samra wrote it nice. Ghamarne. Okay, GH. Okay, perfect. So we did the kh sound, which we represent as a kh or a number 5. We did the r sound, which is the r basically, but we just roll it more in Arabic. We did the kh, kh, which also, as I said, we represent as a number 5, and the gh, which is the letter rein. Okay, yalla. We will move to the next one. Yalla, before I move to the next one, let me tell you something. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, you can do that because there sometimes I also go live and I upload longer lessons. But mainly, if you want like intensive and more serious lessons, I have maybe more than 350 videos on my YouTube page. So there you can go on, like TikTok, I use it for fun. It's really fun to do the short expressions, just phrases, a word here and a word there, and we talk about culture. But if you want to learn like really intensively, there are lessons on YouTube. Something else I want to say, if you want to learn any language, in my opinion, social media is very important nowadays because there is a lot of free material. But at the same time, there will always come a point where if you want to take your language learning experience to the next level and learn it properly, you need a roadmap. And that's why I have my 30-day Lebanese Arabic challenge courses. They come with a roadmap that takes you from point A to point B to point C, step by step. You're moving up in your learning. learning procedure. So these are very, very intensive courses, the 30-day Lebanese Arabic Challenge courses, i.e. Levantine, and there are levels all the way from absolute beginners to advanced. I have absolute beginners 30-day challenge, beginners 30-day challenge, general 1 30-day challenge, general 2 30-day challenge, and till the end. If you want more information, you can always leave a message under any of my videos, or you can go to my Instagram, leave a message, or I'm gonna leave my email address under this video. You can always get in touch if you're interested in doing one of the courses. There are two types of courses, either 30-day challenge with my students live on Zoom, or 30-day challenge pre-recorded courses if you need flexibility, and they also come with Q&A sessions always. Okay, yes, all my channels have the same name, Globetrot with Arabic, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. Yalla, let's go to, we're done with the R, and we will go to the number 7, which is the letter Ha. Look at the actual letter in Arabic. It does look like a number 7, no? That's why whenever we want to represent this letter, typing informally or speaking informally to friends and family, we like to use a number 7, or a lot of times people use just the regular H or a capital H. Again, as I said, there is no right and wrong, okay? Personally, when I'm speaking to my friends, it's easier to type the H, I do the H, but with my students, I always put the number 7 so that I can teach the difference between the number 7, ha, and the H, which is like hotel. So, before I start pronouncing it, let's remember these punctuations, the short vowels, the harakat, we call them in Arabic. This one is the fatha, and it has the a sound, a. This one is the kasra, which is under the letter here, and it's e. The sound is e. And this one is the little comma, the dhamma, and it's the u sound. Now, this letter, ha, again, my students struggle with it. It's not h as in hundred or hotel. It's a ha. If I want to clean this, okay, let's say it's glass or my glasses, I'm not going to go like and clean it. No, you really push the air out. You go like, and you clean. And here, there's my window. I go like, and I clean it. And I saw someone who, I saw a video on TikTok from a comedian. She's really funny. And it's a good idea. She gave a very nice idea. Let's say you open, her name is, I just forgot now. So you open the can and you have of Coke, let's say, and you drink it, okay? And you go like, yeah, that it's the ha sound. It's not h, it's ha. Maya, yes, Maya, that's it. She's the one. She's a very funny comedian, Lebanese. Go follow her. So ha, okay, so together with the u, it's hu, hu. It's not hu. Yeah, let's say out loud with me. Mish hu, hu, hu. Okay, yalla, ulu ma'i. Hu. This one. Not the word now. Ha, ha, ha. Okay? Yalla, ba'd marra. Again, say it out loud. Ha, ha, hu, hu. And hi, ha. I'm exaggerating. Of course, when I'm gonna speak Arabic, I'm not gonna go like ha, hu. No. But it's better to exaggerate now and then reduce it than not say it at all. You see what I mean? Yalla. Ha. Ha, hu, hi. This one is which one? Okay, I'm just gonna mix it up and say a sound and tell me if it's correct. Hu. Actually, I have to cover this. Hu. Sah? No. This one is what? Shu. Shu has sought. What's this sound? Ha, sah, okay. And I'm gonna cover it before I show you. Hu, hu, sah, hu, hu, aw la, la, mish ha. Shu hayda, hi, sah, hi. Okay. And this one, hi, hi, aw la. Shu. It has a dhamma. What's this little comma doing? Hu, yes. Okay. Hu. Okay, so عنا hu, hu, ha, and hi. And try to squeeze your throat when you're saying it, like. Like, if it's difficult to put the e or a or u after it, first try to say the and then add the other one. Like, hu, hi, ha. Okay? Yeah, like, كتير منيح. I have the word, you see, A-R-F, 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 A-R-F. And then a number 7 makes it harf, harf, harf. Whenever we have one syllable words, by the way, like harf, harf, they are a little bit difficult to pronounce. That's why we tend, even as native speakers, we tend to add a to them to make it easier to pronounce. Like, if you say harf, it's a little bit more difficult than harif, harif, okay? Harif, harif. So you're adding a r, here, just because it's easier to pronounce. Harif. Harif يعني a letter, yes. But it's not the letter that you're writing and sending to a friend. No, the letter of an alphabet. Harif, okay? Harif. What's one very famous word we use with the h? Thank you so much. I'm happy I helped. What's another very, very famous word we use in all the Arabic countries? Habibi, yes. And a lot of times you will see people write, you see, you're already writing it with an H, capital H, or even sometimes write people write it with a lowercase h, or a number 7. All of them are okay to write. Again, there is no right and wrong way of writing spoken Arabic, specifically when it comes to using the Roman alphabet or the numbers. So I did a video before and I was talking about how we write the Roman alphabet or we use the English letters, and some people are telling me these are not English numbers. Fine, I know they are not, like, the origin is Arabic numbers. It doesn't matter, as long as we're talking about how we're pronouncing what represents what letter. We don't need to go into all these, you know, details that don't change anything. Okay, so far we did the خ, خ, حرف الخ, KH, or number 5. We did GH, غ, غين. We did the normal R, ر, حرف الر, ر. And we did the number 7, which is the ح. And here we have number 2. Number 2 is actually this Hamza, Hamza, it's the sound. But when it comes to Levantine Arabic, specifically Lebanese Arabic, and also Levantine Arabic a lot of times, we pronounce the letter qaf in standard Arabic, which is qa, qa, the qaf, like capital K. In Lebanese Arabic, we don't pronounce it. We pronounce it 99.9% of the times as a instead of a q. For example, but except when it's like a very formal word or like proper noun. For example, Qatar is written with a qaf. In Lebanese, we don't say Atar. No, we say Qatar because it's like, it's a proper noun and a formal words as well. Like, yes, somebody wrote albi. In standard Arabic, it's written with a qaf, qalbi, qalbi in standard Arabic. But in Lebanese Arabic, we drop the pronunciation of the a and pronounce it as a, albi, albi. And that a number 2, as I said, the same number 2 represents that q, which we pronounce as a e, and it represents the hamza in Arabic, which is the a. What's this a? Let me talk about it. It does actually exist in English. We call it a glottal stop. But the difference is that in Arabic, we see it also in the beginning of the word and at the end of the word. Like, I always give this example. Do you actually say apple or apple? What do you say? We say apple. There is a before you pronounce the word apple, you're actually saying apple. That's the glottal sound. That sound is a glottal stop. Now, that glottal stop exists also in the middle of the word in Arabic and also at the end of the word. Before I give you some examples, let's try to put them with the sounds, okay? Let's say I wrote to you B A, just a B A. How would you pronounce it? Yalla, you will not be able to say it. It's just ba, ba, B A ba. But if I write a B A and then I put a number two after it, I'm not saying ba. I would be saying ba, ba. I like to exaggerate this now and exaggerate it with me as much as you can. Ba. It's better to exaggerate than not to say it, because some people just say ba, okay? It's ba. The same, if I wrote a B-U, it would be boo, boo. But if I write a B-U and number two, that would be boo, boo. Here I wrote a number two followed by a, so it's a. If it's, now this number two, a lot of times when it's at the beginning of the word, like apple, I like to avoid it and I don't write the number two just to make it easier and less confusing to students. For example, elbe, my heart, I can write it 2-A-L-B-E, elbe. But I like to remove it like here, Yusu wrote it, A-L-B. It's already obvious that it's a, okay? But when it's in the middle of the word or at the end of the word, I actually prefer to write it. Like in this word, I'm gonna cover the number two. We have mu, M-O-U, mu, and then we have T-A, M-A-R, mu, tamar, mu, tamar. That's wrong. And by the way, this word means conference, but that's not how we pronounce it, because there is a number two in the middle, which is the hamza, which is this one here in Arabic. And actually, we use a number two because look, in Arabic, this one looks like a little number two. That's why we represent it with the number two. Okay? So this one is mu'. I'm exaggerating. Nobody says mu' tamar. Okay? We say mu'tamar, mu'tamar. Okay? But let's exaggerate. Better than not to say it at all. Okay? Mu'tamar, mu'tamar. Are you saying with me out loud? Right. Right. Yes or no? Mu'tamar. But if you keep on saying exaggerating, with time it becomes mu'tamar. Mu'tamar. And becomes softer, of course. Okay? Mu'tamar yani conference. There is something very famous we eat for breakfast in Lebanon. What is it? Shoo. It is bread, it has thyme inside. We put it in the oven, the guy in the bakery, he puts it in the oven like this. What is it called? We can eat it, it has also cheese flavor, and it has the sound. Shoo. Yeah, za manouche, yes. Okay, look how Yalla Bibi, look how, one second. Yalla Bibi wrote manouche. If we want to write it, yes, you're all writing it without the number two. If we want to write it with the number two, how would we write it in European? Like if I, like Jess Haddad wrote manouche, okay? Fine, if I already know the word as an Arabic speaker, I will immediately know it's manouche, right? Yes. And if I don't know how to speak Arabic, it's good to put to your friends the number two so that you make it easier for them to actually pronounce the manouche. Good. Not number three, because that would be a manouche. Remember, it's not the number. I still didn't do the number three for today. We're coming to the number three. Number two. Manouche. Okay? Manouche. Or manaish, or as I said, there is no right and wrong way of writing this, okay? So, yes, manouche is pronounced differently in other Arabic. I'm not sure in other Arabic countries if they say it differently. In Lebanon, we say manouche when it's one, it's just one manouche. Or in general, we can say mne, 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 one syllable, mneish, 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 mneish. Can be like manouche in general or more than one manouche, okay? If I'm going to buy more than one manouche, I say raiha ishtri mneish. I'm going to buy mneish. I didn't specify how many, okay? So maybe that's the difference. Manouche Neish. In that case, I would write it M-N-E to I-S-H. Neish. Okay? So, we did the number two represents the sound. Or the Q in Lebanese, which is pronounced as a . We did number seven, which is the H. We did GH, and which is the R, and we did the H. Let's think about something to remember the sounds, okay? For you to remember the sounds. So far, the GH, remember, just put a code next to it, gargling. You're gargling. That's how you can remember it. Number seven. Remember cleaning glasses. Make these notes so you don't forget. Number seven, cleaning glass. Okay? So, number seven, cleaning glass. G-H, gargling. Then you have the K-H. What did I tell you, K-H? What code did I give you to remember the K-H? It's either a number five or a K-H. It's a preference. Shoo. It's the spitting sound. So make a note next to it. Spitting sound. Okay? And number two, you can maybe write like a pause, because it's a pause in the middle of the word, like man ooshe. Okay? It's a stop. It's a stop. Think of it right next to it, glottal stop. Okay? And we did the R, R, like a R. Just right next to it, roll your R's. Okay, so you remember to really roll your R in Arabic. Now, number three, in my opinion, the most difficult, because most of my students struggle with this one the most. Number three, in Arabic, the letter is called Ayn. It's not A, it's A. This one has a fatha on top. This fatha gives the A sound, the A. So the A with the A will be ah, say with me out loud. Ah, ah. And this number three looks very similar to the actual letter in Arabic, you see, just looking to the other direction. Okay, this is the letter in Arabic. That's why we like to represent it when we're writing with the Roman alphabet and we want to use numbers. We write it a number three because it looks very much like the Ayn. Okay. So, yalla, let's say together. This one has a fatha, so it's ah, ah. It's not a. When I cover the number three here, it will be a, but it's not, it's ah. Okay, let's think of an angry dog. Make a note next to the ayn. Angry dog. Not barking dog. You know when a dog goes angry and he goes like that's the sound. Okay, that's where it comes from. Now, see, ah, ah, you're pressing, okay? If you're choking yourself, it's ah, 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 okay? If you press really, you don't have to kill yourself, but if you press really hard on your throat and you try to say ah, but you can't, you know, it goes like ah, 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 okay? So that's the ah. And we represent it with a number three and a ah, ah. Okay. No, if you do this lesson, you will need a lot of water when you finish, if you're doing it out loud with me. This one is a kasra. It has the E sound because it's under the letter. So it's not E, no, it's I. Now, something that my students a lot of times do, they go ah, and then they add the E and it becomes I. That's wrong. It's immediately going to the E, yes. But the more you practice it, the easier it becomes. Okay, Kev? So it's I, I, not I. No, not E. It's I. Say with me. I, I. Okay? I actually have another lesson on YouTube explaining all of this. You can find it if you go to my page and you go to the playlist Arabic pronunciation. I'm gonna upload this there as well, and you can watch that one. So maybe if you do two different lessons, there's always something you pick up, okay? Different, and something new you can learn. So yeah, let's say with me. I. I'm exaggerating. No one in life ever says this, okay? But it's better to exaggerate when you're learning and then reduce it. So, عي, عي, عي. For example, عيد. It's not Eid, like, you know, when the celebrations are happening and in the West now they call it Eid. Oh, it's Eid. No, it's not Eid. In Arabic, it's عيد. عيد. Okay? Even the name عمر. In the West, they call عمر's Omar. No, it's not Omar in Arabic. Okay, in English, it's fine. You can say Omar. But in Arabic, it's عمر. عمر. Okay? عمر. عمر. Now this one was داعي, and with the Dhamma once again, let me pick it up. With the Dhamma, what is it? عو. 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 Okay, it's not عو in life, but try it. It's not عو, it's عو. عو. So ع when it's a, عو when it's a u, and عي when it's followed by a e. Okay, yalla, let's repeat them one more time before we try it with the words. Which one is this? ع, عو, أو عي. شو? Thank you. ع, عو, or عي. Angry dog, remember. شو? I'm waiting. ع, عو or عي. Yes, Sophia. عا. Good. Not a miss. It's عا. 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 Thank you. Thank you so much. Foxin. Okay. This one. Is it عا. عو or عي? عا. عو or عي. It has that little comma which is called the Dhamma. شو? عو. Yes. او. عو. Okay, and the last one is with a dash under, like tilted dash under the letter, which is the kasra. It gives the sound. I'm not gonna tell you. So together with the عين, is it عو or عي؟ عي. Yes, عي. كتير منيح. Very good. So for example, I'm gonna give you two options. Option number one, alam. Option number two, alam. Which one is correct? Alam, number one. Alam, number two. Which one? Aya wahde. Yes, number two is the correct one. Alam. And alam يعني flag. Okay? Flag. When it's a long a, alam means people. You see? So, alam. Alam. Flag. عالم means people, or it also means the world. عالم. Okay, for now, let's just learn flag today. عالم. It's not alam. You see, if I cover the number three and pronounce it alam, alam, the meaning even will change, and it will become a pen. Thank you. And it becomes a pen or a pencil. But it's عالم. عالم. Angry dog, remember. So this one, yalla, I'm gonna pronounce two ways, you tell me which one is correct. I'm not gonna exaggerate, so it becomes a bit more difficult, okay? Number one, عنب. Number two, إنب. Which one? Again, number one, عنب. Number two, إنب. And it means grapes, yes. Yes, number one, عنب, عنب, عنب. كتير منيح. مش إنب, غلط. عنب. عينب. And I'm not saying عينب. No, it's عينب. I'm exaggerating. عينب. 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 Okay? يلا. خلاص بس دي يدي لليوم. Enough for today. But before we go, two things, okay? Let's do a quick revision about how you're going to remember these sounds. And before I go, again, I want to remind you, it's as I said before, to those of you who just came in, it's very nice to do TikTok lessons, YouTube lessons, to try to teach yourself Arabic. But at the end of the day, if you want to learn properly and really learn the details of the language, the grammar behind it, the proper foundation, it's very important to do it with a structure. And for that, I have 30-day Lebanese Arabic challenge courses. And when I say Lebanese Arabic, it's Levantine Arabic spoken Widely spoken in the Arab world, widely understood in the Arab world. So if you master it, you will be understood in any Arabic country. So there are, in these 30-day challenge courses, I give you a roadmap, I give you a structure, and you know exactly what you will learn in day one, and day two, and day three, and day four, all the way to the end of the 30-day challenges. So it's very important to have a roadmap and to have achievements and goals to achieve one after the other and after the other. So you actually really speak the language, okay? So there are courses all the way from absolute beginners to advanced. There are 7 levels of courses, and these are courses I do live with my students on Zoom and pre-recorded. People do them on their own because they need flexibility and they cannot do a lesson every day at the same time. But even if you're doing it on your own, there are Q&A sessions, so you won't be alone. There you can ask your questions, you can come ask your questions. And my students who did it, they know, like, they just text me on WhatsApp, I answer their questions, I'm always there with them, and I always nag them to do it, and they are never left alone, okay? And to be honest with you, after COVID finished, things started to change because people are going back to normal life, went back to normal life and to work, and it's becoming more difficult to do lessons at the same time every day. That's why they're choosing the pre-recorded. So I'm only opening classes whenever there's at least 4 students in class, okay? Yalla, before I go, let me quickly, I'm gonna check your comments later on, okay? And see if you have any questions, yalla, type them now. What was I gonna say? Yalla, just very quickly, how do we remember the sounds? Make in your head like an imagination, like a list, notes of 5 things to remember. Okay, the angry dog, which letter is it? Yalla, which letter is the angry dog? Which one? The next live lessons, by the way, will be from June 22 until July 21. Yes, yalla. So, angry dog number 3. Okay. The pause, the glottal stop. Think of also the apple. Do you say apple or apple? It's apple. So which one is that? The stop, the glottal stop. The pause. Yes, number 2. Very good. Cleaning glasses. Cleaning glasses. Which one is it? Cleaning glasses. Yes, number 7. Cleaning glasses. Then we have gargling. Which one is it? Gargling. Yeah, I'm waiting. No, gargling. Yes, gargling is not number 5. No, it's a. Which one is it? No, number 5 was the KH, optional. Gargling. No, not the number 5, no. 3 people said number 5, no. Not sure about 6, no. No, I gave you something else, what? GH, okay, R, and we spoke about the word Rebe, which is a forest. Rebe, okay. Yeah, write it down so I know you remember it now. Gargling is GH. Which one is the spitting sound? Remember the spitting sound. What? I'm gonna show you, but I want you to type it first. It could be the number 5, or number 5 could be possible, or the KH. Yes, correct. Okay. Yalla, I think that's enough for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me check questions. If you have questions, please type them now. So, because there's so many comments, I don't know if I can. Do you go live on a certain day or a time? Maybe I should be more organized in that. I don't. I just think, okay, I have time now. Let me go live. Okay. But maybe I should do it. But if you miss the live, it's okay. I always upload. I download it and I upload it to my YouTube page or to my Instagram page, Globetrot with Arabic. You can follow me there if you want. Okay. Yes, the comments, Manouche. Da da da. Do you do one-on-one tutoring classes? For the time being, no, because I'm doing so many things at the same time. I'm creating courses. I do the 30-day challenge courses. I'm writing a dialogues book, which is coming soon, hopefully next month. It's been 1 year, I say next month, and I'm not organized about it. But no, this time really, I want to finish it in 1 month. I'm doing a podcast, so many things. So, but hopefully when things are calmer, maybe I go back to one-to-one lessons. But if people, for I say this to my students, people who do the 30-day challenge on their own, the pre-recorded, they can do the Q&A sessions, and the Q&A sessions, honestly speaking, they're like one-to-one lessons because most of the time students don't even come to them, you know what I mean? Because the courses are very clear, they say. You know, I just give a compliment to myself. Okay. I picked up some in the Middle East when I was a teacher, but very little. Yeah, okay, why not? You can start learning. Thank you for all of you who are saying you like my lessons and all of that. Thank you so much. And if you want more information about the actual courses, what's your, I don't have an, for now, as I said, I'm not doing hourly lessons. And if you want more information about the courses, you can get in touch. My email is sharig@globetrotwitharabic.com. I will type it under some of my videos, or you can just go on, click on my Instagram page, and you will find the form. Thank you so much. And how many languages do I speak? I speak four and a half: Arabic, English, French, Armenian, because I have Armenian roots. And shukran ktir. And Italian, I tried to learn Italian like 10 years ago and I lost it, but I can manage to have a like a conversation. And I'm trying to learn Tagalog recently, just a few words, and I am starting to understand how hard it is on my students sometimes. Okay, yalla, I'm gonna go now, and thank you for watching. Bye guys, bye.